What's happening, guys? It's Adam here from CyberDog and welcome back to another review video. Today is about antivirus software and we're going to be taking a look at the well-known and well-respected Norton Security. So Norton offer three main subscription packages on their website. This is the standard, deluxe and premium options. There's also a much more basic antivirus plus option, and if you check the link in the description you'll be able to see a comparison of the differences. So first up, one of the main differences is the number of devices that you can run the software on. The higher the level of your subscription, the more devices you'll be able to use. And when it comes to the main feature, the anti-spyware, antivirus, malware and ransomware protection, obviously all three are going to cover you here. Now all three are going to give you PC cloud backup, but the difference is going to be in the amount of storage you have available. All three options are going to give you firewall protection, and they're also going to give you a password manager and the 100% virus protection promise. This basically means that if you do get a virus on your system that their experts cannot remove, they will give you your money back, which just goes to show how confident they are in their level of protection. And next up is the first feature which you actually miss out on if you have the standard protection, and this is the parental control. If you're not a parent, obviously this doesn't matter, but if you are a parent, it's well worth looking at the deluxe and premium options. Now this next feature I find particularly impressive, and that is their VPN. Now with most antivirus softwares out there, you either have to pay more money to get a VPN added on, or they give you a very limited basic VPN where you can't choose your location and you only have a certain amount of download limit per day. But with Norton, not only do you get access to their full unlimited VPN with their premium subscription, but you actually get the same one with the standard and the deluxe package as well. And last on this list is their SafeCam feature, which you have access to from all of their packages, and we'll get into a little bit more detail on this later on in the video. So with all this information, I went ahead and downloaded the deluxe version, which I feel is definitely the best value for money. It was an easy installation process, and as it was installing, it actually gives you some great tips and information on cybersecurity in general. So when you first open up the app, it looks slightly different to some of the other antivirus softwares that I've used recently, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. The layout is nice and simple and it seems easy to understand. So the first tab is the main security section where you'll run your virus scans on your computer. So I'll come back to take a more detailed look at this in a minute. Underneath this we have dark web monitoring. Now the dark web is a part of the internet that can't be accessed by a normal browser. Cybercriminals use the dark web to steal and distribute your personal information. So what this feature does is it constantly scans and checks the dark web for anything that you wouldn't want to be online. And what you can do here is you can select the certain information you want it to look out for. Up next we have their VPN, which I mentioned earlier, and I was particularly impressed with this VPN, not only because of the unlimited data allowance, but because of how quickly it actually connects to each region. If you want to know more about VPNs, I've done a great video that explains in detail about what they can actually do and all the benefits of using them. Now underneath this is where you can set up your cloud backup if you want to make use of that, and then we have the password manager. This is where you can store all of your passwords for every online account you have, and you can securely access this for multiple devices, and this means you never have to type in another password again. And last on the list we have the parental controls. In here you can set up a different profile for each of your children, and you can monitor their internet usage and have control over what they can and can't access. Now let's get back to the main feature of any antivirus software, and that is to scan our computer for malware and other virus threats. Now we'll get into how efficient these scans actually are in just a sec, but I wanted to show you how much of your system's resources will get used up whilst doing a full scan. So before I start the scan, my CPU is running at about 10% of its capacity. When I start the scan, you can see this quickly jumps up to between 30 and 40%. And in fact, if I actually skip forward a little bit, you can see that it actually maxes out my CPU. Now for me, this scan took around 20 minutes, but if your computer's a little bit slower, be aware that it may take a bit longer. So you want to make sure that you have nothing to do on the computer during this time, as it's very power intensive. Now the results itself of my test showed that it found no threats whatsoever, but that's because I've been testing various antivirus softwares recently, so any threats would have already been cleared out. So to get a more accurate idea of how efficient these scans are, I decided to look to the experts who run these tests in extreme detail. So the results from the German testing lab AV Test showed that from January in 2017 through to March 2020, Norton detected every instance of known widespread malware and of previously unseen zero-day malware in every month that they evaluated. However, 1 month later in April, this 100% track record dropped to a 99.5% detection rate of the zero-day malware. These figures were only matched by one other antivirus software, and that was Kaspersky, who I did a review on the other day, so check the description for a link to that. And it's worth noting that over the 28-month testing period, Norton came up with 33 false positive detections. Now, when it was put through its paces by another testing company, an Australian lab, AV Comparatives, in 2019, Norton detected an average of 99.6% of malware threats from February through to May. But from July through to October, it maintained a perfect record of 100%. Now, one last feature that I wanted to mention was the SafeCam feature. What this does is it actually takes your webcam and it blocks all access from the internet from using it. This means that nobody's going to use any malicious software to be able to view your webcam remotely. Of course, when you need to use it yourself, you can include certain apps and programs in the list of allowed applications, so the webcam will still function as it should when using these. So Norton clearly deserves its recognition as one of the best antivirus products out there. Its easy-to-use interface is simple to get to grips with, and it has a host of features which cover all aspects of cybersecurity. Its virus scans may be a little intensive on your system's resources, but they get the job done, and there's not many other products out there that offer such an all-round service. So this is why, after my testing, I highly recommend using Norton, and I'll put a link in the description below so that you can take advantage of any deals or discounts that they may have on at the current time. If you feel like you're not quite ready to commit to one product yet, I'll also include some links to some other reviews I did of other antivirus softwares, so you can check those out and see if they might be better for you. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you've learnt something. Make sure you always stay safe online, and I'll catch you on the next video.